In this section, we will learn to conduct harmonic analysis in ETAP. So before conducting the harmonic analysis, I would like to discuss about the harmonic and its effect on the power system. So let's see what harmonics are. Harmonics are electric voltages and currents on the electric power system that can cause power quality problems. So harmonics is as old as the generator. So in a generator, since the field windings are not uniformly distributed, then they will create distortions in the voltage and current waveform. So the distortions at the point of the generation is very small, like about 1 to 2%. So let's see what causes harmonics. So mainly harmonics are created by electronic equipment besides the generator. Now with the nonlinear loads drawing in current in abrupt short pulses. So the short pulses causes distorted current waveforms, which in turn causes harmonic currents to flow back into other parts of the power system. So in case of loads, there are two classifications, that is the linear load and the nonlinear load. For linear load, the current drawn is proportional to the voltage. Loads like heaters, motors, etc. And in case of nonlinear loads, the current drawn is not proportional, that is disproportionate with the voltage, such as the static loads, power electronic loads, etc. These creates distortions, and this distortion superimpose on the fundamental frequency. So let's see the harmonics over here. So here we have the distorted current waveform over here, and this can be resolved into several sine waves over here. And this is the fundamental frequency at 50 Hz for a 50 Hz system, and the third harmonic will be 3 times the fundamental frequency, then it will become 150 Hz, and 5th harmonic, 7th harmonic and the 9th harmonic. So in power system, we are mostly concerned about these 3 harmonics over here, that is 3, 5 and 7, and we will neglect the 9, 11 and so on. This is because the magnitude of the 9th harmonic is very small compared to that of the 3rd, 5th and the 7th. So let us see what are the problems caused by harmonics. Overloading neutral conductors. So for a balanced 3-phase supply, there will be zero neutral current flowing. So the neutral current is not very large. And in case of buildings having large amount of computers or large number of computers as some PSS and other power electronic loads, then the third harmonic current will get added in the neutral, and as a result the neutral conductor will have to be very large to accommodate these harmonic currents. So mostly this would cause the overloading in the neutral conductors and also cause fires if the neutral conductors are not rated for this. And overheating of transformers. So in the case of transformers, we know that the no load losses are mainly due to the hysteresis loss and the eddy current loss. So the hysteresis loss is proportional to the frequency, whereas the eddy current loss is proportional to the square of the frequency, and this results in additional no load losses, and this also cause problems for motors as well, and nuisance stripping of breakers. All circuits contain capacitance and inductance. These will have one or more resonant frequency. So when any of the resonant frequency correspond to the harmonic frequency which is provided by the nonlinear load, then harmonic resonance can occur. And depending upon the circuit, if it is series circuit or a parallel circuit, this will result in voltage amplification or current multiplication. So this will cause nuisance stripping and also damages in the power system. Overloading in capacitor banks. So capacitor banks are usually rated to operate at the power frequency, and large amount of harmonics can cause overloading because the capacitive reactance is inversely proportional to the frequency. And so if the frequency increases, the capacitive reactance decreases. thereby acting as a sink. And then the skin effect. The skin effect is applicable to the cables as well as conductors, because the skin effect is directly proportional to the frequency. The skin depth is inversely proportional to the square root of the frequency. So greater the frequency means the skin depth will be small. So this will cause more losses, and then the total harmonic distortion or the THD. This is a quantity which is used to measure the distortion in power system. So this is the ratio of the sum of powers of all the harmonic component to the power of the fundamental frequency. So I believe we have gone through most fundamental theory of harmonics. So let us enter into ETAP to conduct a harmonic analysis.